Hi, I'm Dr. Avillion. I work at the House Clinic, and today we're going to be talking about otosclerosis, its treatment, what to expect for surgery, and after surgery. So, in order to proceed, we need to have a brief overview of ear anatomy and how the ear works. This is a diagram of the ear. The yellow is the outer ear, to include the pinna, or the outer part of the ear. That's often where you have earrings, the ear canal, and the eardrum. The red highlighted region is called the middle ear space, and this houses the ear bones. There are three ear bones, the malleus, the incus, and the stapes. The blue area is called the inner ear. It houses the cochlea, where the sound is processed, that sends the sound to your down an auditory nerve to your brain, and it houses the balance canals. This next diagram focuses in on the middle ear ossicles. As you can see, this first one is the malleus here. The second is the incus here. And the third is the stapes here. Highlighted in orange is the stapes foot plate. This has contact with the inner ear fluid. The way we hear sound is sound comes into the ear canal as sound waves. You can see them here. They vibrate the eardrum. The eardrum then vibrates the rest of the ear bones, the malleus, the incus, and the stapes. That stapes foot plate then pushes on fluid in the inner ear, specifically the cochlea, sending sound waves down the cochlea to specific regions based on the frequency of the sound that we hear. Certain regions will then vibrate and send a signal to the auditory nerve, which then sends the signal to the brain to be processed.
Hi, I'm Erin, Associate Director of Education and Global Hearing Health here at the House Institute Foundation. Thank you for watching our video. If you would like to support research, education, or global humanitarian efforts, please consider donating by clicking the link in the description box below. Be sure to check out our other videos, like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you can get notified anytime we post. Thanks.